Wow, we are all welcome back from our 1 week of continuous assessment on this online learning platform. I'm so excited to have you back. I am Mrs. Olayinka. I'm very sure you have done very well in your continuous assessment. Don't worry, we're sending your report to you on your mail, and then you will see what you have done and how you've done it in your mathematics, English, quantitative, verbal, science, and PHE. You see your results, and then you understood why, what you have been able to do and how to do better. So today in mathematics class, I'll be teaching you something very special. It is called statistics. It is called what? Statistics. Okay, now I'll be telling you some things in this class, so get yourself ready with your writing materials and pay attention to the class. Okay, at the end of this class, I will expect you to be able to tell me what central tendency means. Then you should be able to tell me mean, define mode, define median, define mode, and define range, and then should be able to work on all four. Should be able to tell me what mode is and work on it, what range is and work on it, what median is, work on it, and what mean is, and also work on it. Okay, now what is central tendency? Now we talk about central tendency. You know that in statistics tends to analyze and interpret large sets of numbers. It tends to interpret large sets of numbers. Now to make the list of numbers more comprehensible, we need to use central tendencies. We need to calculate the central tendency so that we make the figures and the data more comprehensible. So what do we now mean by calculating the central tendency? And as I said, calculating central tendency means it points the person calculating, that is the statistician, toward a centralized, repeated, and average numbers. These three things I cycled, they have what they mean. Now when we talk about centralized, we are talking about median number. Median number. Okay. Then when you talk about repeated, we're talking about mode numbers. And when you talk about average, we're talking about mean numbers. Do you understand now? Centralized talks about median, repeated mode, and then average mean. Average numbers talks about mean. Now let's quickly go to what they mean. Okay, now we have mean, median, mode, and range. What do they mean? Okay, now what is mean? Mean is the average or norm. Average or normal. Norm means normal. Okay, what, how do you get it? You add up all the values to find the total. That's the first step. Then divide the total by the number of the value you have. Okay, I have an example here. I have 2, 2, 3, 5, 5, 7, 8. Let's quickly do it on the next slide. 2, 2, 3, 5, 5, 7, 8. 2, 2, 3, 5, 5, 7, 8. So let's have here 2, 2, 3, 5, 5, 7, 8. What do you do to it? Add the values together. 1, 2. Have your pluses in between. Then what do you do? Divide by the number of figures you have there. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Divide by 7. So when you add it together, you have 2 plus 2 give us 4, plus 3, 7. 7 plus 5, 12. 12 plus 5 give us what? 17. 17 plus 5 give us what? 24. 24 plus 8 will give us what? 32. So we say 32 divided by 7. And what do you get? You get your 4.57 as your what? As your answer. And that's your mean. Good. Let's quickly go to the next slide and let's talk about median. Now we're talking about median. What does it mean? It means the middle value. It means what? The middle value, the value in the middle. Now we have figure here, 5, 13, 9, 7, 1, 9, 2, 9, and 11. Now we have two ways of arranging figures. You can either arrange the figure in ascending order or in descending order. When you talk about ascending order, the figure goes up from 1 to 13. And when you talk about descending order, the figures comes down from 13 to 1. From 13 to 1. The figures goes up from 13 to 1. Okay? Okay, sorry about that. The figures goes up from 13 to 1. 13 to 1. Okay. Now, it goes up from 13:1. It comes down, that's descending. It comes down from 13:1, and in ascending, it goes up from 1 to 13. In descending, it comes down from 13:1. So you get the middle value. So in this question we have here, the figures have been arranged in what? You can tell me from 1 to 13 will be what? Ascending order. So you now arrange it. We have 1, 2, 5, 7, 9. Let's quickly do it on the next slide. 1, 2, 5, 7, 9. Okay. Then we have 9, 9, 11, 13. 9, 9, 11, 13. So how do you get your middle number? You remove this, cancel this as well. You cancel the other one and the other one and this and this and this and this, and they will have the median number in between, and this is the median, the median number. And in some cases where we have two median numbers in between, then you do what? You add the two median numbers together. Suppose we have another one here, we have another 13 here. Okay, that means what will you do? That means we have two median numbers. What do you now do? You set the two middle numbers, add them together, and divide by 2. That is 18 divided by 2. You get your 9. That is if the figures in between are 2. But if not, you still have just the one in the middle as your middle number. Okay, let's quickly go to the next question, which is mode. Looking for mode. Mode is the most frequent number appearing. Most frequent items appear. So we have two questions here. Now we have 5, 6, 5, 7, 5, 8, 9, 5. So how many times does 5 appear? We have 5, 1, 9, 1, 8, 1, 5, 2, 7, 1, 5, 3, 6, 6, 1, 5, 4. So 5 appears 4 times. So 5 is the mode, because it appears how many times? 4 times, where the other one appears once. Now let's come to the second example here. We have 5, 1, 6, 1, 5, 2, 6, 2, 5, 3, 8, 1, 6, 3, 5, 4, 6, 4. That means 5 and 4 appears 4 times. Then 5 and 6 are the modes, because they appear most frequent in the question. Let's now quickly go to our range. Range of students talks about the highest subtracting the lowest. So when you have range, it talks about you move the lowest from the highest. Now in this question, we have 13, 13, 14, and then to 16. The highest figure is the 16th figure there, and the lowest is 13. So what do we do? Okay, we say 16 minus 13. That's the highest minus the lowest. What do we get? You get our 3, and that's our range. Okay. All right. Let's now come to a conclusion on this topic. Now, what do we talk about mean? What does it mean? The sum of all values divided by the total number of the values. The sum, okay, over the total number of the value. Maybe 7, 6, 5, whatever. The median is the middle value. That is, you have to arrange the data in order, either ascending or descending order. The mode talks about the most common value, or the most frequent value. And the last one is the range, which talks about the highest subtracting the lowest. The highest minus the lowest. You subtract it from the lowest. Okay, now we have come to the end of the class. Let me quickly find out if you have been able to do this. It says, find the mean, median, and mode, and range from this set of numbers. Okay, we have these numbers. I want you to put it down on your paper, your book, okay, and help me to find the mean. Don't forget, you know how to find the mean. You can remember, who can tell me how to find the mean? Okay, good. Now, from these numbers as well, find the median. Find the median of this number, arrange it either in ascending or descending order. Then from these numbers again, find the range. I hope you still remember the range. How to find the range? Look for the highest number and look for the lowest number. Okay, look for the lowest number. Now you find the mode. Remember the mode? The one that frequently appears. The one that appears most. Okay, all right. I'm sure you've been able to do that quickly on your paper. You can snap it and send it to my mail. I will see. Thank you so much for your time. I'll be sending you a class activity tomorrow. Make sure you do it very well. Bye.